Hey, Southport family, we're back for another day's reading. We're officially in chapter 2 of 1 Corinthians today, and I think you're going to really like this. It's pretty applicable, I think, to our current time. I know that I've got one here and then one behind me, and I'm sure a lot of you guys are self-quarantining too, just trying to cut off your limitations with the outside world right now in order to keep the most vulnerable among us safe and as healthy as possible. That being said, right now we're all seeing a ton of just things that make us feel anxious or overwhelmed. And I think 1 Corinthians 2 actually has a lot of applicable things to it. Let me tell you why. So 1 Corinthians 2 kind of displays this thought. Remember, Paul's teaching a group of people who are divided currently over their favorite teachers. And the reason he gets into this argument is because he is trying to get them to understand, hey, listen, it doesn't actually matter who the teacher is because they're only getting wisdom from God. So the person who's teaching doesn't actually matter. It's rather, what are they teaching and is it wisdom from God? So he says this to illustrate his point. For the Spirit searches everything, even the depths of God. Okay, so this is the Holy Spirit. For who knows a person's thought except the spirit of that person which is in him? So also no one comprehends the thoughts of God except the Spirit of God. Now, and this is key, we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit who is from God, that we might understand the things freely given us by God.
Hey, look at me.
And we impart this in words, not taught by human wisdom, but taught by the Spirit, interpreting spiritual truths to those who are spiritual. So in essence, what Paul is saying is, listen, it doesn't matter who is teaching. What actually matters is that the spirit within them is from God. And since that spirit is from God, that spirit knows what God's thoughts are. It's the only one that understands the depths of God. And so that's what's actually being taught, is the wisdom that is from God, not some type of human wisdom or spirit of the world. So that being said, we'll get into chapter 3 tomorrow. You're going to love it. I love chapter 2. It just really makes so much sense when you begin putting it in the context of, hey, let's not be divided over particular teachers or favorite leaders. Instead, let's just be excited about Jesus because he's the one that makes all of this possible. Anyways, he's the one that makes the church possible, the one that makes our understanding of scripture possible, all of it. It is Jesus who we are focused on, and let that be our focus as we move ahead in these uncertain and kind of crazy days. Love you guys, and we'll see you tomorrow for 1 Corinthians chapter 3 with a little bit of a twist on these videos I think you're really gonna like. We'll see you then.
Goodbye.